witnessed the first time in a long time a Cleveland Browns playoff victory. It's been 3 decades, almost about 3 decades now, and the Browns finally have a playoff win on, you know, big time win too, against the Pittsburgh Steelers. I mean, 48-37, that was the final. It was 35-10 at halftime. Browns just needed to, you know, get a couple more scores in, and they put the game away. You know, when Ben Roethlisberger throws it 60-plus times, that is not a recipe for winning the game. And I said this, I think everybody knew this, that if the Pittsburgh Steelers were going to be completely, you know, going to be completely one-dimensional and throw the ball 50, 60 times a game, they weren't going to win this game. And, you know, it cost them. You know, it cost them. Big Ben threw 4 interceptions. There were 5 turnovers, including a opening fumble that got recovered in the end zone by the Browns, you know, to open up the game, and the Browns just didn't look back. Nick Chubb, Kareem Hunt, out there feasting, eating. I mean, sure, the Browns, you know, the Browns may have gotten a little bit tired, you know, in the second half, once the Steelers started scoring and stuff like that, and they were, you know, getting a little bit inept on offense. But hey, this is a recipe for disaster. You know, I mean, the Steelers had a clear advantage. They were at home. The Browns were missing guys. They were missing their head coach, Kevin Stefanski. I mean, they were missing, you know, players due to COVID, coaches due to COVID, not just Stefanski, other guys too on the coaching staff. It doesn't make any sense. It does not make any sense whatsoever for the Steelers to just get completely bulldozed like that. And this is what it's been like for the past 2 months. The Steelers getting completely bulldozed by another team. Thank God this season is over for the Steelers. There is some problems out here in Pittsburgh country that need to be fixed. It is time. It is definitely time. I don't think, you know, a lot of people were like, well, you know, Big Ben, you know, he can come back, he can lead us to the playoffs. I mean, he did. He led the Steelers to the playoffs. People, I think he should have come back. Not particularly, you know, when you have an elbow injury like that. You know, I know people who've had elbow injuries, broken elbows, and that is a hard thing to come back from, especially when you're a quarterback that can throw with that broken elbow, you know, from the part where you broke your elbow. You know, it's hard. And the fact of the matter is that the Steelers, they had the case of the dropsies. You know, Ebron, Deontay Johnson, dropsies all season long. It didn't make any sense. It doesn't make any sense. The Steelers defense just completely collapsed in the game. You know, it's a damn good defense, but when it gets overran, oh boy, does it get overran. Just a rough performance by the Steelers. Very rough. And, you know, the Browns get the move on. They get to face the Chiefs next week. So, there you go. Big time game there. The second game, the middle game of the day, was the Saints and the Bears. Now, honestly and truly, the Saints should have gotten a bye. There is, I thought this was stupid from the moment it got announced, all the way back in what, January of last year, when we found out that we were getting 14 teams into the playoff now. I thought it was stupid. The Bears did not deserve to be here. There was Nickelodeon slime everywhere. Yeah, the Bears didn't deserve to be here. Did not deserve it. Could not even compete with the Saints this time. I mean, these guys were 5-1 to start the season, and they lost what? They lost what, 9 out of their last 11 or something like? No, not 9 out of their last 11, like 7 of their last 11 games. I mean, sure, they had a 3-week stretch in which they won, but I mean, come on now. This is mediocrity. These guys were 8-8. Should not have been in the playoffs. Should not have been in at all. It doesn't make any sense. And, I mean, the Saints just steamrolled them. We're talking time of possession, steamrolled them. We're talking Alvin Kamara on the ground. He came back just as I had thought, you know, steamrolled them. You know, everybody was eating on the Saints, just steamrolled the Bears. Saints should have gotten a bye. I mean, Bills probably should have gotten a bye too, but I mean, the AFC was so strong this year, you know, I don't think it was really justified, you know, to leave 2-10-win teams out the playoffs. But Saints definitely should have gotten a bye, honestly. So I think this experiment should be over, you know, the whole 17 playoff, but it's permanent, so it's not like it's going away anytime soon. So what about Ravens Titans? Well, Derrick Henry got stuffed, 40 yards, absolutely nothing. You know, Titans had a chance to go for it, 4-for-1, 4-for-2. You know, at the Ravens 40 yard line, didn't do that, punted it away. You know, and you let Lamar Jackson and company run the ball all over you. You let Lamar Jackson and company do what they wanted to do. You let Lamar Jackson and company just allow them to control the pace of the game. You allowed them to control the pace of the game. And when Ryan Tannehill was forced to throw, that is not going to happen. Not with Marlon Humphrey and Marcus Peters out there. Not with those two guys out there. Recipe for disaster, especially with an interception late by the Titans. A recipe for disaster. It's a damn shame. It's a damn shame that it had to end this way for the Titans. You know, 2,000 yard rusher Derrick Henry didn't even show up. It's a damn shame. It's a damn shame. But the Ravens get to move on, so there's always good stuff there. And they will take on the Bills, you know, Bucks will take on the Saints, you know, the Rams will take on the Packers. Chiefs will take on the Browns. Oh man, what a time it is going to be next Saturday and next Sunday. Now that we're back to pretty much normalcy around here with NFL playoffs, now there's only 8 teams left. And, you know, one of these teams wasn't completely expected. I did not expect the Cleveland Browns to be here. We all did expect this, but here they are. They are here, and they could be here to stay. They could give know the Chiefs a tough fight, but I'll talk about that Friday. So, NFL divisional round, preview, predictions, all that good stuff. It's going to be Friday. Man, can't wait. Can't wait for that. It's going to be some other stuff throughout the week as well, you know. So, stick around Monday, throughout the day Monday. Stick around throughout the week. Sure, I'll have something else out in the middle of the week. We'll find that out, you know, very shortly. But yeah, the divisional round is set, and the NFL is ready for 4 more games this next Saturday and Sunday. It's going to be fun. I cannot wait for these 4 games. I really can't. So what do you think? What do you think about the Steelers? You know, talk about the teams that are eliminated. What do you think about the Steelers? You know, what do you think about the Titans? You know, what do they need to do? Because I think they need to do some things too, but not too much. What in the world should happen to the Bears? Because, I mean, there is definitely a problem in Chicago, and I don't think it's being addressed. You know, there is a problem in Chicago. There's a problem in Pittsburgh, and there's a problem in Chicago. Something needs to be fixed. So for both of those teams, what do you think needs to happen there? And how do you feel about the Browns advancing? We knew the Saints were going to advance, so, you know, don't even. But do the Saints have enough firepower, though? Do they have enough firepower to stop Tom Brady a third time? Because in the playoffs, you know, you can beat the team twice in the regular season, but third time's a charm. Third time's a charm for everything. What about those Ravens? You know, what about those Ravens? What can they do to Josh Allen? But again, I'll preview all that stuff Friday